Hi friends, I'm Jayne. This week on Behind the Play, I'm going to be teaching you about how to control the tempo of a fight. The fight that we're going to be taking a look at took place on Lijiang Tower Control Center during our fight against the Los Angeles Gladiators.
A lot of that was due to having a strong ults economy
right. And
winning fights before Dallas had a chance to set up. So game plan definitely stronger here on the fly from the Gladiators.
On this map, both teams rolled out in the so-called New Goats composition. That's basically Bunker with Mei and Reaper. Now, while neither team controls the objective, this is called a neutral advantage, or simply fighting in the neutral. Now, the reason for this is that no particular team has any incentive to play fast or slow. They just want to win this first fight. However, pretty early on in this fight, Sure4 plays a little bit too aggressive and gets picked off. At this point in time, it's no longer a neutral advantage. The Los Angeles Gladiators make the decision that 5v6 and without their main DPS, they want to back off and lose this fight as quickly as possible. Although winning the fight is great, we want that ult charge, so we try and chase them down through the hallways and push them back to their spawn while Sure4 is trying to regroup with the rest of them. Cooldowns are exchanged, neither team is really able to find a kill, and at this point the advantage that we had with Sure4 being picked off is slowly dwindling away. With this, we now want to play as slow as possible. We want to be slowly backing off towards the point, but not taking a fight. First of all, because there's not a large enough advantage to justify it, and also, backing off slowly and retreating towards the point makes them use more cooldowns, and that takes longer as the Orisa can't move forward as freely since every single shield placement requires a brand new cooldown for the Gladiators. At this point, the longer the Los Angeles Gladiators wait to engage us and try and take a fight, well, the more progress we get on the objective, so we're not really in any rush, happy to sit on our side of the point, forcing the Gladiators to take the dangerous trek across the halfway point and eliminate us, or at least force us off the point. Unfortunately, at around 20% objective progress, Decay launches a great blizzard and walls off OG, preventing his retreat. Now this makes the fight 5v6 in favor of the Los Angeles Gladiators. However, unlike the initial fight in which the Gladiators chose to retreat in this situation, we are going to stand and fight. And this is for two reasons. First of all, even if we don't win this fight, we want to make it as long and drawn out as possible. Ideally, we want the Los Angeles Gladiators to even use more ults for the privilege of taking this point from us. On top of that, the fighting has been going on long enough that we're coming up on 4 ultimates, 5 if you include OG's Bongo when he returns from spawn. We use all 4 of these ultimates trying and succeeding to hold onto this point while OG returns with his Bongo. AKM trades for Decay's Mei at about 36% objective progress. Then things start going in our direction. What was originally going to be a lost fight actually might be turning in our favor, as Void gets demeched at about 52% objective progress. Sure4 goes for a sneaky teleport, tries to clutch things out with his Death Blossom, but unfortunately Note is there and ready, and well, he goes down, and this really pushes it in our favor, allowing us to clean up and remain in control of the point.
They are going to stall this out for quite some time, so there might be some value in using these ultimates. Try and pop the supercharger now, and that means they're going to win the barrier battle, and actually, you know, they hold on to the point.
Wow, I'm impressed. It was not looking good, Sure4. Waltzing the backline with the Death Blossom, not going to get anything done. That was kind of comically bad, but Dallas Fuel, to their credit, holding off the Gladiator.
This turn of events actually allowed us to get 99% on the objective before the Gladiators finally took the point from us. This put us in a great situation. Being at 99-0 on a control map allows you to just hoard ults and then use them all at once to practically guarantee a retake and a victory. And that retake came in the form of a great bomb from Note, with Closer following up the boop and AKM's Death Blossom for insurance. Unfortunately, also dying in the process. And really, that just goes to show you that, in this fight at least, Death Blossom had a 0% survival rate. Good ultimate. This evened up the score on Lijiang Tower at 1 apiece, and we eventually did go on to take the map. Now, unlike last week's play, where Taimo used the Symmetra in order to flank around on Volskaya, which was a strategy that came from the staff, this play here is a great example of in-the-moment decision-making and leadership, specifically from OG on the Orisa. This is a great example of professional game sense and something that you might try and apply to your ranked games as well.